It is a story about a mentally ill patient in 1989, I think, who hires a lawyer to get out of the hospital, basically. And the mentally ill patient, she hired this lawyer who is a very, very efficient lawyer who has closed down all her access to inner emotional life. And of course, this mentally ill patient, she's very open and very spontaneous, almost in a childish way. And it becomes almost like a yin and yang story where, because of this patient's spontaneous way of dealing with emotions, she managed to open up for the lawyer's emotions. And they become create the most beautiful friendship. So, yeah, it's a beautiful, beautiful friendship story.
And you have two beautiful talents in those lead roles. Can you talk to us a little bit about Helena and Hilary and what it is about each of them that makes them such a perfect fit for this combination?
Both Hilary and Helena, they are, for me, some of the two greatest actresses in the world. And the fact we were able to get them in the same film was beautiful. And throughout the film, you know, it was all built on trust, and they trust me and they trusted each other. So we just had a great time working together.
The conversation about how we deal with mental illness, both here and around the world, continues to this day. What are you most hoping on that subject people take away from the experience of this film?
I hope that this film will raise the issue about how we deal with mentally ill patients. Of course, things are different today, there are different issues, but still we have to respect mentally ill patients. They are still human beings.
What the way it started was, I was driving my car in Los Angeles, which is what we do most of the time, is drive our cars, because we have to always drive from one place to another. And I was listening to public radio, and there was an interview with a lawyer who worked for mental health clients. And he said that he loved his work so much that he started it in law school, and 20 years later, he was still doing it. And I said to myself, my God, I want to interview someone who has such a passion for his work. And I interviewed him, and because I had worked in a mental hospital when I was in college and I knew the plight of mental patients, I said, I want to tell a story about people with serious mental issues. Is there a story that you have to tell me that I could make a movie out of? And he said, yes, the story of Eleanor Reese, who is played by Helena Bonham Carter in a brilliant performance. And that's what inspired me to do it. And then I interviewed Colette Hughes, one lawyer, Morton Cohn, another lawyer, Colette played by Hilary Swank, Morton Cohn played by Jeffery Tambor, and I learned more and more about Eleanor Reese, and I learned that she changed their lives. She didn't just change the law. She didn't just fight to change the law. As a person, she changed the lives of people she knew. And that's what inspired me to tell the story.
The nun just saw her as Eleanor and took her totally as Eleanor. And their friendship was very close.
Can you talk about working with the astonishing talent that is Miss Helena Bonham Carter?
Yes, absolutely. Oh, she was wonderful. The first day on the set, she was absolutely open to me. We'd never worked together. She was, we were, you know, like friends. It was, and Hilary too. Both of them were great.
I'd like to talk a little more about Helena. She did research for the role. She prepared incredibly for it. And every day watching her shoot was a joy for me because of what she brought to the role. The honesty that she brought to the role moment to moment was just astounding and moving. And people will see that when they see her performance. She's magnetic and moving.
It was a hell of a part, this one. I was originally approached to do this film about, well, it was just in a different decade. I was like, I think in my 30s, and I was asked to play Colette, which is the part that Hilary Swank plays. And it's a story between a lawyer, Colette Hughes, who is still alive and is here tonight, and Eleanor Reese, who was a lady who was mentally, you have to be so careful these days with the PC thing, but she was mentally disabled, slightly brain damaged. And she was mentally ill, had paranoid schizophrenia, possibly wrongly diagnosed. But was every time she went to hospital, she was over-diagnosed. She was over-medicated. And she always felt that she was treated like a nobody and no one listened to her. And so she fought for the right to have a say over her own treatment. And Eleanor was perfectly competent and responsible, but she wasn't given a voice. And that's what basically she needed to be heard. That was the overriding objective that I played in playing her. But she, as a woman, was full of complexities and lots of contradictions of being very vulnerable and intolerable, and there was a whole different, lots of different layers. But I had to be careful not to be playing the mental illness. I had to play her, and not let it'd be a portrayal of the disease. That was the whole point. She felt like she was crippled by all these side effects and that she wasn't heard. And she as a character was fantastically liberating to play because she had no filters. She was just says what she felt, so that there was a freedom and an innocence to her, which I love playing.
As much as this is a film about mental disability, it's also about an extraordinary friendship, a relationship between two very unlikely friends. Can you talk a bit about working with Hilary and what you're hoping audiences most overall take away from that part of the story?
Everything was done by the last, right down to the last line. So I hadn't even met Hilary until the read-through, literally the day before we started shooting in San Francisco. So I thought, Jesus, there's going to be either chemistry or no chemistry. And as soon as she walked through the door, I thought, thank God. And that she is the most wonderful woman, and she's unbelievably generous, and so she was, and she was a she also loves tennis, and it's like playing tennis with a pro. Not that I play tennis that well, but their friendship is extraordinary, and I think it's a surprise to Colette. Was a surprise to Colette, who is Hilary's character, and Eleanor was desperate for any kind of contact or any kind of recognition. But I don't think she realized quite how much an effect, how important she ended up being in Colette's life. And I think Colette learns as much, if not more, from her than the other way around. She is lovable, Eleanor. I mean, she's very irritating, too. But there's something which is so authentic. She's utterly herself, utterly honest. And herself, and also she had a big heart. So when she seeks to change the law and try and fight for the rights of those who are intellectually disabled to have a right over over their treatment, she's not doing it just for herself. She's doing it for everybody else. Mort, the real Mort Cohen, who I met on the film, he said she was like a trade unionist in the ward. In the hospital, and she was the mother hen to everybody. And she, whatever, how much pain she was in, she would always be looking after somebody else. And that's something considerable.
Would you react the same way?
Probably. But only because I've now got Eleanor, because she's taught me.